excited to know that this is just the beginning. Absolutely. I don't know if anyone is big on social media or looking back. Have you heard of the Time Hop app? You know, where it looks back and shows you like a year ago today, something you posted, a picture, that kind of thing. Looking back through pictures and just remembering what took place a year ago, and just so much anticipation going into this first launch Sunday 1 year ago. And I remember conversations that I got to have with people that were wanting to know about the church. And I sat down with one individual, and he asked me one question. I'll never forget it. We're sitting there at lunch, and he asked me, why does Huntsville need another church? Like, there's streets I drive down, and every corner there's another church. And it, I don't know if it was just the youthful zeal in my heart, but I remember just being so passionate about, listen, if there's another house being built, there needs to be another church being built. If there's more subways and McDonald's being built, there need more churches. If there's one person who has not heard the message of Jesus in this city, we need more churches. And believing that and passionate about it and knowing that God had something specific to say about it, Exodus 3. For our launch was something so powerful that the Lord showed me and still carries me every Sunday into these services, knowing that the Lord said, Exodus 3:7, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I've heard them crying out because of their slave drivers, and I'm concerned about their suffering. Our God is a God who is very aware of the needs in this city, and the concern that he has is for the hearts in this room and people who may be going through suffering, that they don't have an answer or a solution. And the remedy is not just God's awareness, but the fact that he moves with compassion towards our hurt. Because verse 8 says, I have come down to rescue them from the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them out of that land and into good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey. And for us, the promise is that when God moves into our life, he takes us on a journey. And today as we worship, I want to encourage you, come along on the journey of God, and it'll be the best decision that you have ever made. Come on, let's worship God today. If you're comfortable, lift your hands, Lord. We pursue you. We chase after you. Take us on a journey to get closer and closer to you, in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm not afraid to die. worship. We have joined all of our other campuses. Come on, Grantsville, say hello to your church family. God bless you guys. So good to see you today. It really is. And the reason why we did it this way today is today, everybody, we're 14 years old. Happy anniversary, Holly. To do today. We're going to kind of mix up the service. If you're new to our church, this is kind of not our normal flow today. In fact, we're going to worship some more at the end of the service. We've got an ending today that I think is really going to be just awesome for every one of you. So stay to the very end today and we'll worship some more then. But we're actually going to take some time now, and we normally even receive our tithes and offerings at the end of the service. And we're going to do that now because we want to end differently. So we're saving that for then. So why don't you give somebody a high five, a handshake. Go ahead and be seated right there where you are. Can you do that? Come on down. Come on, greet somebody. Say hello, hello, hello. Awesome. Go ahead and find a seat. Our campuses are going to lower their big screens down so they can enjoy this part of the service. And God bless you guys. So glad to have all of you here today on this day of some liquid sunshine going on outside. Yeah, it's good to see you. And yeah, normally we give to God together at the end of the service. We're going to do that right now because of the way we want to end on this anniversary celebration. So I know you're not normally prepared now, but if you had it in your heart to give today, go ahead and prepare that. And as always, if you're a guest with us today, don't feel any pressure to be a part of this. Part of the service. This is really for those who call Highlands home. You guys, just make yourself home. We wanted this service to be our gift to you. And we do welcome all of you guys that are here. I think all the campuses have already done this. If you're here at our church for the first time, we're so glad you came. You couldn't have picked a better Sunday to find out who we are and what we're all about than today. We're going to talk about that a lot today. And the worship guide we gave you really explains who we are as a church. Talks a little bit about our values and all that type of thing. And so, should y'all hang on, we're going to pray. Don't pass them yet. Y'all, somebody's ahead of me over there. I see buckets flying everywhere. Y'all hang on. We got to bless it. We're going to bless it first, all right? That's some anxious givers over there in the prison. I won't say where, but it's... Anyway, so... I do want to pray, and I don't normally get this opportunity. This is something the campus pastors do. But because we give at the end, and on the first Sunday, we always ask the campus pastors just to pray a blessing over, especially on the first. Man, we're not on the first Sunday. This is the first. This is February 1st, you know, and to be able to honor God. Tithing is not an amount principle as much as it is a priority principle. To say that before anything else, God, you're first place in our lives. And the promise of Scripture is that when we do that, if you seek first His kingdom, He takes care of you. I promise you, at the better end of that deal, if you want God taking care of you, not you taking care of yourself. And so we honor God with that. And of course, we as a church do everything we can to invest in ways that expands the kingdom of God and makes you proud. And so we do it with a lot of intentionality and frugality and strategy. And so like always, you just obey the Lord. More than half of you don't even give this way. This is becoming archaic. The old-fashioned envelope and whatever way. A lot are giving online or through that text-to-give option. It's amazing how times are changing. So you just obey the Lord at your own convenience, however God shows you. We always leave that between you and God. We've never asked you for anything. We're not going to start today. We just ask you to do what God shows you to do. So you just obey God this moment. I do want to pray for you. You're an amazingly generous church, almost at twice the national average. I want you to know that. And it's allowed us to do a lot of things that, honestly, we pay cash for everything, where everything's paid off. We owe nothing anywhere. And it's just, honestly, it's because of the grace of God and your generosity. And so I want to just say thank you. You're an amazing church. And so, Father, right now, as we dedicate our tithes and our offerings, and as we give to you, Lord, we give it out of a heart of gratitude. God, you've done way more for us than we could ever do for you. And so, God, in this moment, Lord, we give back to you, really, which is already yours. And then we give our offerings, God, just out of our heart and out of the abundance that you've given us, Lord. But God, it's more than just worship. It's more than just obedience. God, it's a pleasure. We love our church. We love what you've allowed us to be able to do here in Alabama and really around the world. And so, God, we invest in it, Lord. Let it produce a harvest of fruit. God, the promise of your word is that we obeyed you. You opened the windows of heaven. God, you rebuke the devourer for our sakes. God, I pray for a blessing over this month of February in every way for your people, God. Thank you, Lord. We give it to you now in our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now you can pass it. Let's take a look at some highlights here.